Stereo and New York City Music Station, Yes FM. Outside, Calvin Harris, Ellie Goulding, 719. Cloudy skies, 13 degrees, or minus 11. All right, how much sleep does Ethan Shanty need to get by on?
How much do I need or how much do I get?
You need. I need at least this amount of sleep to be able to function the next day without taking a nap.
This personally? Or
I'm talking you.
Like, how much do I think I need?
How much do you need to be okay enough to get by?
You know, if I don't get about 6 hours of sleep, I'm pretty much wrecked. But, you know, so, sometimes I have to settle for five just because I'm a pretty bad sleeper.
Right.
I don't fall asleep fast, and I don't stay asleep unless it's like the weekend, you know, because I get thinking about a lot of stuff all the time, and I'm busy, and I'm a worrywart. So, yeah, I don't sleep very well. So if I get six, I'm lucky.
Okay.
Yeah.
In your age group, you should be sleeping 7 to 9 hours.
Yeah.
That's how much they say. As far as, you know, ages and how much sleep you should be getting, do you have a newborn, couple of months old? 14 to 17 hours is what they need.
Is what the newborn needs.
Newborns. Yeah. 4 to 11 months is 12 to 15. Toddler, 1 to 2 years, 11 to 14 hours. Preschool, 3 to 5 years, should get 10 to 13 hours.
Okay.
I guess about 9. There are 9 to 10, I guess, is what my preschooler is getting. School age, 9 to 11 hours. Age is like 9. Yeah, she's about 9, usually. Teenagers, 8 to 10. Young adults, 7 to 9, as with 26 to 64-year-olds. 7 to 9 hours. Must be nice. And if you're an older adult over 65, you need 7 to 8 hours.
Mm-hmm.
I think when you get up early in the morning, no matter what time you go to bed, when you get up at like 4 o'clock in the morning, you feel it. But
doesn't
like,
matter how much sleep you get, really.
No. No,
is that what you're going to tell me?
I'm saying usually I'm getting, it's about 7 these days.
You're going to bed pretty early then.
Before 10, yes. And I'm up before 5. So it's about 7. And by like, you know, 2 o'clock, you're tired. No matter what time you know, 7 hours, you think, oh, that's not bad. But on the weekend, though, if you go and sleep from, say, midnight to 7, you're fine.
Yeah.
It's weird. Same amount of sleep, different time you get up, you feel fine.
I think there's something to be said about getting up before the sun. It really, really screws with you. It screws with me, at least.
Yeah.
But, you know, for me, I've always hated going to sleep. I've always gotten probably less sleep than I should get, except for on the weekends, because, you know, I push it as much as I can do, and then my body just kind of collapses on the weekends. Not all the time, but sometimes. But, like, even when I was in grade school and high school, I wanted to push that bedtime limit, you know?
Right.
So, you know, if I had to go to bed at, like, you know, it was, I don't know, when I was in, like, 7th grade or something, it was, like, 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock, and I was like, no, I want to stay up. And then my parents just stopped caring.
Right.
And, you know, I think sleep is a waste of time. If I could get rid of it, I'm serious, if I could get rid of it and just have, like, 2 hours of sleep a night and have a nice, awesome, intense dream and then wake up, be all set.
Okay.
Thanks.
Get more info now. Thanks, Ethan.
You're welcome.
At the Murders in the Man page at YesFM.com, 723.